I had a friend come over. I was going to demonstrate the Gatling Stirling to him, and I could not get this thing to start. I was quite surprised by that. If I spin this, I can hear some of these displacers going back and forth. If I disconnect all of these tubes, then obviously nothing's moving. So I'm starting off with an X on this one cylinder. Nothing. And the next one, nothing. And the next, nothing. That one's working. That one's working. That one's working. Okay, so for some reason, only three of the six displacers are going back and forth because of the action of the piston. So maybe it's got some dirt in here, whatever. As much as I don't want to, I'm going to take this hot end apart. I took each of these apart and looked at the piston, the liner, and the O-ring, and they all seem to be okay. Take the hot end. Those displacers are moving. You can't tell how many are moving. And these have to be very free. They have to move with a very small differential pressure that's on the piston or by the heated gas. I took a wire and put it up in there, and each one is free to move. One thing I have noticed, as this runs for a while, that displacer is going back and forth, bang, 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 and it's hitting the end of this tube. And given time, every once in a while, you'll see one of these that's moved out just a little bit. And there's enough inertia from that hitting that it'll move that tube out. So you want to go in here and make sure they're pushed in all the way and that the tube is sitting square with the base. To my knowledge, nobody's shown one of these apart before. That will end here. And you wiggle that. And I can see there's a silicone O-ring in there. And I'm going to make a wild guess that that's the same size O-ring is what's on the cylinder head, and that is a displacer. Get that O-ring out of there. This will not be easy to get back in there. Inside of the tube looks perfectly clean, and this is the displacer. And it slides back and forth. We can hear it hit on this end, but more than likely we're hearing it hit on that end. So I don't see anything wrong with that. Feel any burrs. I'm just gonna have to check each one and see if I can find any lint or dirt or anything that's inside. This is an O-ring from the displacer tube, and this is an O-ring off of the liner that seals the cylinder head. They both appear to be the same. On the ruler here, they appear to be 18 millimeter OD and 2 millimeter diameter. This O-ring off of the displacer has little shiny flecks on it. Metal dust, might be some debris from machining. We'll look at one of the others and see what that looks like. As I take this apart, I'm finding bits and pieces of aluminum on the tarp here. When I look down inside here, that little piece there, that's a piece of aluminum. And right here in this hole, there's a piece of metal swarf that's just about to fall off. That's a piece of metal right there. And a bunch of other little specks and bits and pieces. So if any one of these displacers has any drag or develops any drag, that will work against the whole engine, and the engine will not start. So I'm going to wash this all out with mineral spirits, blow it out with compressed air, and try to put it back together clean and see if it'll go again. Washed with mineral spirits, blew it out with compressed air, rinsed it with denatured alcohol, blew it out with compressed air again. That's what it should look like, clean and shiny. Putting this together again is a little bit of a chore. I'm taking the molybdenum disulfide and I'm putting a little bit on that shaft with a Q-tip. And then, just a little bit in the center of that displacer. That stuff is pretty slippery. Displacer tube, put an O-ring around it, slide that down in there. Now I need to try and push it down here, then I come around to the other side and push it down here with something that doesn't have any sharp edges on it. Then I do the same thing over here and over here. So every 90 degrees, you push it down in there. And the reason for that, and then it all popped up again. So anyway, I push it down on this side, push it here, and then on the other two sides, and a little bit of that'll be bowed up. That O-ring's trying to stretch, and so we gotta compress it and push it down in there again. And I'm gonna do this off camera because I can't see what I'm doing. Okay, I've pushed that down, and it's all down below the surface. I wiggle this around, and I turn it a little bit, and then go around and make sure it's still down as far as it can go. It has to go up against this groove on this inside. Three more to go. Again, the reason for pushing it in on the four corners is that that O-ring, if you don't, that O-ring will try to stretch, and as you work yourself around, you're going to have a big loop of O-ring sticking out here. So you got to put it in on the four corners and gradually start working it in. And by the time you get around to the fourth or fifth one, it's getting easier to do. Then when you get this last one, these two are in the way. Surprisingly, that went back together in about a half an hour. I thought it would take all day. I only had the six original O-rings for the hot end. Always a chance that you're going to cut an O-ring trying to push it into place. Might be a good idea to order a few spares ahead of time, just in case. And you can't really tell, but it sounds like they're all moving. Wishful thinking. Going around here and testing these one by one. That one's working. 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 And the last one. That one's working. Okay, all six are working. After putting this together, those displacers sound like they're snapping around there pretty good. The tank is fueled. Let's see if it runs. So if your Gatling Stirling quits, now you know how to take it apart and fix it.